Ordered. We now recognize the chairman of the Subcommittee on National Security and the individual who first began this investigation, Mr. Chaffetz.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman. And I thank all the members on both sides of the aisle for being here today. I thank the chairman for his tenacity in pursuing this. I believe we have a moral imperative to pursue this. We have four dead Americans. We have others that are critically injured. Our thoughts and prayers on both sides of the aisle are with those people and their families. We cannot thank them enough for their service, their dedication to our nation. We also thank the people here on this panel for participating, as I know all four of you care deeply about this country. This is a very serious situation. We have to understand how we got here, because before 9/11 2012 and after the revolution there in Libya, it was a very tumultuous and difficult situation. I'd ask unanimous consent to enter into the record a document that was provided to us by Mr. Eric Nordstrom. It was dated October 1st. And
Without objection, so ordered.
I'd like to read, Mr. Chairman, the last paragraph of that statement that he sent to us. It is, again, 230 security incidents in the country of Libya. Quote, "These incidents paint a clear picture that the environment in Libya was fragile at best and could degrade quickly. Certainly not an environment where post should be directed to, quote, normalize, end quote, operations and reduce security resources in accordance with an artificial timetable," end quote. Of all the things I've seen and read, that to me is one of the most disturbing. And I appreciate the guts of those that stood up and will provide us this information, because it does take guts to do it. Now, I'm going to ask that we have some photos here. We have to understand how we got here. Broad daylight, in June of 2012, two-car convoy carrying the British ambassador was ambushed, military style, with rocket-propelled grenades in Benghazi. Sorry, these pictures seem to be out of order. What you haven't seen before, there we go. This was an attack literally weeks before what happened in Benghazi. Next slide, please. And the next. And the next. And the next. These pictures are of an attack that happened in Benghazi. The first was the so-called fish bomb. This is the compound in Benghazi before the attack. Go to the next slide, please. The second bombing was an improvised explosive device that was placed on the north gate, breaching the wall. It was a test by terrorists, and it was successful. And we didn't respond fully and adequately. We didn't acknowledge it. We didn't talk about it. We pretended it didn't happen. It was a terrorist attack on a U.S. asset in Libya, and it was never exposed. We pretended it didn't happen. Well, guess what? The third time the terrorists came to attack us, they were even more successful, killing four Americans. I believe, personally, with more assets, more resources, just meeting the minimum standards, we could have and should have saved the life of Ambassador Stevens and the other people that were there. Now, this was a massive attack, no doubt about it. We're getting new details. And I believe, Mr. Chairman, the reason we have those details is because of this hearing. Mysteriously, the State Department decided to give a press briefing last night. We weren't invited. Certain news outlets weren't invited. Any reasonable person looking at the security situation in Libya had to come to the conclusion that it was tumultuous at best. I wish I could tell you everything that I learned. I did go to Libya. I did drop everything. I had the same type of notice that was given to the Democrats. In fact, the State Department sent an attorney to follow me in my every footstep. So to suggest he didn't have an opportunity to go is absolutely wrong. I wish I could share everything that I learned there. But we have to be careful about the sensitive, secure information about sources and methods in a classified setting. I think some of the information that the State Department has shared oversteps some of those bounds. Let us be careful today to not reveal some of that classified information. It's been too hard, too difficult to get basic information. I will tell you, though, that when I was in Libya, good part of the day, never once did a person ever mention a video. Never. And I am fascinated to know and understand from the President of the United States, from the Secretary of State, and from the Ambassador to the United Nations how they can justify that this video caused this attack. It was a terrorist attack. Let's be honest about it. Mr. Chairman, I appreciate the time. I look forward to this hearing. May God bless those men and women who serve us. I thank you for being here. And let's always remember those who serve this nation. I yield back.
I thank the gentleman. And the gentleman is correct. Both sides were informed once we'd gotten clearance for Libya.